God bless you. My name is Ade Ajayi, the parish pastor of RCCG, Thanksgiving House based in Chelmsford, United Kingdom. And I bring the daily devotional Open Heavens Reflection to you, written by Pastor E. Adebe. And the topic before us today is titled Taking Grace for Granted. And the main Bible passage, which is taken from the book of Romans, chapter 6, verse 1 to 5. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in saying that grace may abound? Certainly not. How shall we who died to sin live any longer in it? Or do you not know that as many of us as were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we were buried with him through baptism into death, that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life. For if we have been united together in the likeness of his death, certainly we also shall be in the likeness of his resurrection. And a memory verse for today, Romans chapter 6, verse 2. Certainly not. How shall we who died to sin live any longer in it? And our reflections. What of the most misunderstood concepts is the grace of God? The grace of God is the free and unmerited favor of God as manifested in the salvation of sinners and the bestower of blessings. There's nothing we can do to earn salvation because it has been freely given by the blood of Jesus. There's nowhere in the Bible, however, where it says that you can do whatever you feel like doing, no matter how sinful, because salvation is free and not by works, which is false teaching being perpetrated by some. Many things in life are free, but there are still conditions for you to be eligible for them. To obtain salvation, you must ask for forgiveness of sin, accept forgiveness, repent from sin, and confess that Jesus Christ is Lord over your life. My brothers and sisters, repentance means to turn away from sin, not just to feel sorrowful about it. If someone continually commits the same sins, then they have not repented. They may feel guilty, but they continue doing it anyway. God cannot be pleased with such a person. But Paul says it so well in Romans chapter 6, verse 1 and 2. Well then, should we keep on sinning so that God can show us more and more of his wonderful grace? Of course not. Since we have died to sin, how can we continue to live in it? It repeats later in verse 15 to 16. Well then, since God's grace has set us free from the law, does that mean we can go on sinning? Of course not. Don't you realize that you become the slave of whatever you choose to obey? You can be a slave to sin, which leads to death, or you can choose to obey God, which leads to righteous living and eternal life. He tells us clearly here that if we continue to sin, we become a slave of sin, which leads to death. Of course, it's talking of spiritual death. Have you been taking grace for granted? You say you are born again, yet continue to sin the way you used to. My brothers and sisters, I want to appeal to you today. Repent today. Don't allow yourself to be a slave to sin, but choose to be a slave to righteousness. Remember that Hebrews 12 verse 14 says, work at living in peace with everyone and work at living a holy life. For those who are not holy will not see the Lord. Action point. Prayerfully follow up 5 backsliders and lead them back to Christ. Pray that they will not take the grace of God for granted. And also pray for yourself that God Almighty will establish you and you continue to be that which the Lord has intended you to be. And the Lord Almighty will continue to make you to be ahead in your Christian work with God and also follow his precepts and obey him till the end. God bless you. God loves you. And have a wonderful day.